In this video, we're going to have a look at the insert tools in Stitchmastery. So in the top menu bar, you can see the word insert, and clicking on this, we have five options. So you have the option to insert a row or rows, and ditto for columns, or insert copied rows or row, and insert copied column or columns. There's also insert chart, and we've explored that in a previous video about having more than one chart open in your Knit2 file, so we won't go into that option today. But first of all, if we come to my chart, and let's say I want to add an extra column just to the right of the edge of my chart. You may have noticed in this menu the final options are all greyed out, and that's because at the moment I don't have anything selected in my chart. So you need to select a column or a row to let Stitchmastery know where you want the new blank column or row to be placed. So to have a blank column placed at the right hand edge of my chart, I need to select the rightmost column. We need to click on the column number, or if you don't have your columns numbered, then just above the column itself will also work. So ditto, you see here I don't have my rows numbered on the left hand side, and that's because this is knit in the round, but if I click just beyond the edge of the chart in the blank space here, it selects the row, so you don't need to have the numbers there in order to be able to select. But just to clarify, you're not clicking on the stitches themselves, because that selects the stitch, so out with the boundary of your chart, clicking either the blank space or the column number, select the column, and simply come to insert, insert columns, and insert columns to the right. So we get a blank column here on the edge of the chart, and just to point out that the output text has updated to reflect this, so instead of knit one, make one right, we now have knit two, make one right, which reflects the chart. You're not restricted to adding columns or rows one at a time. So for instance, if I wanted to add five blank columns at the edge of my chart, it's very easy to do this. So I'm going to click on the five for the column five, and then I'm pressing the shift button on my keyboard, holding that down while I come over and click on the one. So I get my five columns selected, and then let go of the shift, come to insert and insert columns to the right, and we now have an extra five blank columns. You can also insert blank columns in the middle of your chart. You're not restricted to adding them on the edges. So if I click on column 13, for instance, insert columns, I'll insert one to the left, and you'll see that comes right here in the middle of the chart and becomes the new column 14. And my columns are numbering, continuing from 1 to 22. The numbering changes to reflect the columns that you've added. Something that is important to note is that Stitchmastery will not allow you to add a blank column into somewhere that would mean it would disrupt a stitch. For instance, here we have a cable stitch which takes up three cells. The program will not allow me to add a blank column right through the middle of this stitch, because obviously then three stitch cable is not going to be workable anymore. If I wanted to turn this into a four stitch cable, then I would need to remove this stitch, just replace it with plain knit stitches, then insert the column, and then replace with a four stitch cable. Because obviously if I just replace it with a four stitch cable, the same rule applies. Stitchmastery is not going to allow me to add a column into the middle, which would break up the stitch. So just to demonstrate, if I click on column 15 and we come to insert columns, then I only have the option to insert a column to the right, which is clear of the cable stitch and not to the left. And if we click on column 16, which is in the middle of the three stitches of the cable, I don't have any option to insert columns either side. So you may also wish to insert copied columns. So for instance, if I decided that I wanted to have this cable, three cables motif coming in another part of the chart, then I can select all of the columns that the stitches are within, so shift and select. And again, we've got three different ways to copy stitches. So you can either use the copy icon, you can use edit and copy, or you can use the keyboard shortcut. So if you're on a Mac, it's Command and C. I'm on Windows, so Control and C to copy. And then perhaps I want to put them into the chart beside column 6, let's say. So I've selected column 6, come to Insert and Insert Copied Columns. And exactly the same, I have the option to insert that to the right or the left of the column that I've selected. So let's insert them to the right. And you'll see we've now got those five columns added in to the right of the column that I'd selected. And inserting rows works in exactly the same way. Select your row or multiple rows that you want to have additional rows inserted above or below, and use the row options as above. So at the moment I don't have a copied row, but I do have a blank row. Insert above, and we get an extra blank row. Something else that's worth noting is that you're not only confined to inserting copied rows or columns from within the same chart. So if I open this other chart, ignore this, if we select a couple of these columns, Control and C to copy, I can ignore that. Click on column 4 and insert the copied columns to the right. Then they copy in quite happily.